Hello, hello, this is Wu Art again. I know you enjoyed the previous video and are so excited about what comes next. In this video, we are gonna learn the way of controlling expression. Then you can just simply animate your motion with a slider. How cool is that? I've included a link where you can download the After Effects project with graphic asset, so you can start from there. Okay, get ready for the excitement. First of all, import the asset. This is the base for the face. Place the sample image for a guideline. Okay, draw the shape for the base of an eye. And add a stroke layer style for the outline. Duplicate the layer and place it to the opposite side. Let's make an eyelid. Pick the color from the sample image and add a stroke as well. Make a lower eyelid. For this one, we need a shape layer for the outline rather than the stroke layer style, because the stroke of the left bottom side is disconnected. Okay then, pre-compose three of them. Readjust the size of the comp. Place it in the right position and duplicate for the opposite side. Okay, let's make pupils. Create a black circle and put it under the eyelid layer. Of course, it needs one for the opposite side. And I'm gonna make a comb for the reflection on the pupil. Create the three white ellipses with different scale. Put it above the pupil. And make this follow the pupil layer. Duplicate one more for the opposite side. Open up an extra preview window. Adjust the detail of the reflection. Duplicate the eye base layer and mask the pupil layer by this. Do the same thing for the opposite side. Turn off the sample image. Okay, let's animate the eyelid. Change the duration of the comp to 1 second. In this composition, the eyelid will be open at the beginning and close at the end. So we need to animate path. Activate animation of every path and press U to open up all of them. Move the keyframes a few frames later. Open the eyelid wide at the frame 0. And close it at the end. Move back to the main comp. I'm gonna use time remapping for these comps. Right-click on the layer and do the time remapping. Then you can control the time of this composition. When you delete the last keyframe, it won't be animated. Okay, let's make a controller for them. Create a null object. Add a slider control effect to this layer. Name it blink. The value range is too wide. Let's decrease it. When you right-click on the value, you will see the Edit Value menu. Click it. Then this window will appear. Decrease the maximum value to 1. Let's use this slider for eyelids. Go to the Time Remap property and pick Whip the slider value. Do the same thing for the opposite side. Okay then, it'll animate like this. Oops. Change the maximum range to 0.99. Okay, it works well. It would be nice to make the position of the pupils affected by blinking. So let's make it happen. Inside of the expression window, you can give a kind of nickname to an imported value. If I name this slide a value of blink, for example, then you can use it from any lines by this name. So I multiply the slider value by 20 and add it to the Y position of the pupil. Then you can see that the position changes depending on the blink value. Okay, copy-paste this to the opposite side. It looks sad already. The default is 0.3. Let's animate the reflection to make it look more tragic. Add the wiggle method to each layer. Create an adjustment layer and add a turbulent displace. Change the values. Add the time value into the evolution. Multiply it by a huge number. Okay, it's enough. Let's add a blinking animation. Okay, cool. Moving on to the mouth. Just using 4 points for the mouth path, I'll show you the reason why. Basic things are the same as the eye base layer. Okay, right. I'm gonna add a null object for each point. Go to the window menu and click this. Then you will see this window. After selecting the path, click this button. Then you will see that it generates null object automatically. You can control the path by this object. Okay, let's automate the mouth animation. Add a slider and change the range. Go to the null object and write down the expression. Basically, the position of object will be affected by the mouth open slider. So the two upper objects should go up and the two lower objects should go down when the mouth is open. So we should multiply different numbers for each side. Then it works like this. The mouth should go a bit down. Let's adjust the value. Okay, let's clip out the face inside of the mouth. Duplicate the mouth layer. Change the fill and stroke setting. And choose the alpha inverted mat for its track mat setting. Expand its alpha area a bit. It works well. Okay, let's make a tongue. Put it behind the face. Add a wiggle path. You can distort a path by this effect. Change the setting to make it look smoother. Okay, then it works like this. Add a trim path effect. I'm gonna make it appear depending on the mouth open value. Open up the slider. I'm just typing in the code instead of pig whipping. It's basically the same. Multiply it by 100. Okay, let's see how it works. Ooh, it's nice, isn't it? I'm gonna use the spatial phase rather than the wiggles for its movement. put the time value in it and multiply a big number. Adjust the values until you get the result you want. Okay, cool. Let's make an anger controller. Add a checkbox controller to the control layer. I'm gonna make angry pupils first. Duplicate the ellipse and resize it. Open up the opacity properties of the normal and angry pupils. I'm gonna make the angry pupil visible when the angry checkbox is on and vice versa. The checkbox has two values, true or false, and those are 1 or 0 in number. So when you put it into the opacity property, it works like this. So you should multiply it by 100. Can you see it? But the normal pupil should work the other way around. They should disappear when the angry value is 1 and vice versa. For that, you can simply subtract the value from 1. Then the result will be the opposite. Put the same expression to both the reflection and normal pupil, and see how it works. Yeah, that's it. Do the same thing for the opposite side. Okay, cool. We need to add these angry marks. Just draw it. Move every path into the one shape group. Adjust its anchor point. Move it into the right place. Duplicate the group and move it. The thickness of strokes are different from each other due to the scale. It doesn't look right, so let's change it. Take the stroke effect out from the first group. Remove the same effect from the second group. And put the stroke effect below both groups. Okay, then the same stroke effect applies regardless of the scale. Type in the wiggle method to both scale properties. Okay, he is annoyed now. We are gonna piss him off soon. Make the angry layer appear depending on the anger controller. Okay, it's time to animate him. But before that, let's arrange the layers. It's a bit messy right now. Press F4 to toggle the layer mode. When you press that mole-looking icon, you can hide the layer by clicking this. You can make them appear by turn off that button, so don't worry. This null object will be the controller of pupils. Parent or layers relate to the pupils. Okay, it works well. Hide them all. Okay, let's animate him. He's getting sad. Because just realize he doesn't have a girlfriend. He's so lonely. Just about to cry. Oh, pity you, poor frog. But after a second, he reckoned that's not his fault. So he's starting to piss off. Against the whole society. Everyone else is happy, except himself. This universe is unfair. Sad.
Sad.
Annoyed. Exploding. Okay, cool. Adjust the detail a bit. add a bit of wiggle to the pupils when he explodes. We can multiply it by the angry value. Okay, it's more dramatic. Make it a little bit stronger. Add a red color on top of the image when he is angry. Put the wiggle method into the opacity property to make it more dramatic. We need to put something behind when the mouth is open. Okay, let's add some effect. I'm going to use the transform effect and the directional blur effect. It's simple. Add wiggle to both the direction and the blur length. Blur length needs a default value. Alright, hide it when the angry value is turned off. And the last things are the hands. Place it in the right place and change the anchor point. Duplicate for the opposite side. He'll shake his hands when he's angry. Add the wiggle method to his hand. And add extra degrees when the angry values turn off for hiding them. Yes, like this. Move the right hand in front of the mouth. And I want to adjust the mouth a little. Make the mouth open value affect on the x-axis of this null object. Okay, and adjust the position of the angry mark. Yeah, then we made Pepe the frog. How was the process? It could be a little bit difficult, but as you've seen, this is really useful. So I highly recommend you to get used to it. Okay then, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. Bye!